leadership changed in the world post-World War II. When the soldiers came back from World War II, a lot of our companies built a very similar structure to the military. So we had somebody at the top that had the big stick, and you grouped everybody into small groups who reported up. And so the chain of command was very, you know, concretely laid out. And then I think what happened is they understood that that wasn't working real well because it took too long to make decisions. And so they decided that they could use secondment or a matrix style structure to make better use of their talent capital. And so we ended up with people who ended up with a business responsibility and then projects and other things that kind of came out. And it sort of showed that we didn't have a very good relationship base, right? Because when I can tell you to do things, you don't get much choice. And the best example I can give you is in the military. If I tell you to give me 10, drop and give me 10, and you don't, it's catastrophic. And that's what our businesses looked like for a very long time. And then it became more, let's share opinions, let's do that. But the people who were in the management piece didn't want to let that go, right? So they had a real hard time with this mobile workforce below. And then I think we moved into a place where technology changed the way we could work. We have a cell phone on our hip. We have a tablet that we carry. We have a laptop that we have. And we went from being able to draw boundaries. And I think that's one of the things that leaders fail to do is to say, it's okay for you to go home and turn off the phone. That we've gone from an 8-to-4 job where leaders knew what you were doing 8-to-4 to a job where they weren't really sure what you were doing, but a percentage of your time belonged to them. And now leaders expect you to be there when they phone you at 11:30 at night. And I think it's changed to the point where there's very poor boundaries. And so an employee or a team member, unless you tell them to go home and shut the phone off, are really in a place of angst because they're afraid if they don't answer that email at 10 o'clock at night that there'll be trouble. And I think there's a room in the leadership world to share a vision that says, yes, you need to balance work and life. And so we've had this continuum from very directed to participatory, and now it's kind of invasive to a degree. Mm-hmm.